So what's up people and welcome to another Alita Battle Angel slash GUNNM video. So today's video was something I didn't particularly have planned. I was going to do another video this weekend on covering two characters, Gunzu and Nurse Gerhard, which I've always wanted to do, but I'll probably do that next week. This week's video is relatively impromptu. Although, you know, yeah, it's kind of ironic to say that considering none of my videos are particularly well laid out. But yeah, this one's a little bit more impromptu, I guess, than the others. And the reason this came out is because of two videos that I saw on YouTube. One was by GenX Strikes Back, and the other was by Revan. And both videos, when I combined them together, kind of intrigued me about something with regards to Motorball. And so I wanted to make this video. Now, of course, before I start, I do want to give my default spoiler alert. This one isn't going to go really too deep into the latter part of the comic because it deals with Motorball. However, it will go into some of the information with regards to Motorball that hasn't been covered in the movie yet. So if you haven't read the first four chapters of Battle Angel Alita comic, and if you don't want to be spoiled by something that may come out in the possible sequels, Motorball sequence, then you may want to turn this off. However, you know, we'll be going into, again, speculation, so I don't know if any of this will be coming out in the sequel, but as always, I did want to bring this spoiler alert out, and as always, please watch at your discretion. Now, the videos that I'm referring to, first of all, with regards to GenX Strikes Back, is the video that he brought out with regards to Keanu Reeves a few weeks back. I'll leave a link to that video in the description section of this video. And it is a very interesting video, so I would suggest you go take a look at it if you haven't. This is with regards to the possibilities in the grapevine that people are saying that Keanu Reeves may be coming out in the sequel, if there is a sequel, which is interesting because there's still this possibility that there is no sequel, but people are already talking about who's going to be coming out. So maybe, yeah, this indicates that the sequels may be higher probability now. But in any case, yeah, people were talking about the fact that Keanu Reeves may be coming out in the next sequel. And of course, that brought up the question of exactly what part he will play. And I gave my little contribution that I would like to see him play Figure 4. And to avoid spoilers, I won't go into who this character is, but of course, if you know this character, you know what I'm talking about. But in any case, now that I think about it, it may require a younger Keanu Reeves, but if there was a younger Keanu Reeves, I think he would be perfect for that role, just because of the fact that Keanu Reeves has played both goofy kind of comical roles as well as really serious action roles. And that would be perfect for this sort of character. Now, other people have mentioned, you know, Radio Chaos as a possibility as well. And I thought that that was really good as well. The only thing is that both roles requires a relatively young character. I'm not exactly sure if the present day Keanu Reeves would be adequate, although CGI seems to do wonders to a person's age these days. However, now this brings up the other video. This is a video by Revan, and he was talking about this short video called The Fall, which I'm very curious in looking at. And he discussed a lot of very interesting topics in there. If you're a comic reader and if you read the first series, then I would think that this video is very interesting because he goes into some of the things that may come out in the movie based upon this short video. So I'll leave Revan's video link in the description section as well. And if you've read the comic all the way to the end of the first series, then that might be something worth checking out. But in any case, you know, there was a lot of things that was covered in there. And we started to talk about many things, of which one of the topics that came out was Keanu Reeves, because I think we both saw GenX Strikes Back's video. And in any case, we were talking about what role Keanu Reeves would be good at. And he brought out a really good suggestion, which was Esdoc. And now that I think about it, I think Esdoc would be a great role. Now, some people may feel that this is not a significant enough a role for somebody as high-powered as Keanu Reeves. However, considering the fact that he does the brooding kind of depressed role very well, I would think that Keanu Reeves would make a very good Esdoc. Now, if you recall, Esdoc, or Ed, was Alita's manager during her time in the Motorball competition. And yeah, he doesn't have to look like Esdoc in the comic. I think he would look really goofy if he looked like Esdoc in the comic. I think, if anything, he just has to look like his usual kind of John Wick looking style, except that he's a lot more depressed than John Wick. Which, if you think about it, may be difficult, because John Wick is pretty depressing as it is, although he is pretty badass. But in any case, yeah, I think maybe a dark suit or something like that, and being a brooding kind of businessman manager would be perfect for the Esdoc that I'm thinking about. And the reason that I thought that Keanu Reeves, somebody who's as good as Keanu Reeves, would be great for Esdoc is the problem that I saw with regards to having Motorball just be part of the next movie. You know, Motorball is a very long arc in the original series. And so to have it finished in about 30 minutes so that you could move on to the more important arcs may actually reduce the essence of Motorball. Yeah, it may not fit as well as some of the other arcs in the original series. However, as I mentioned in my Motorball video, that there is very significant character growth that you see in the Motorball arc. And if you kind of rush it through, then you may lose a lot of the depth, the character depth that comes out in that particular arc. And so I was really worried that this may not work out if we just turn it into kind of a sports action bashing thing. However, instead of trying to revolve the entire Motorball arc around just Alita, which is how the comic went, and it went through a significant amount of, you know, character reflections, if we focused a lot of it around Esdoc and, of course, his rival, Jashugan, and how Alita's character gets mixed up into that, that may turn out to be a very good alternative that you may be able to complete in a lot shorter time. And so what I wanted to do is just go over what I thought may be a very interesting scenario. This is, again, speculation and some ideas of how they may be able to create something that will go relatively quickly but still have character depth. Now, if you recall, Esdoc and Jashugan were rivals. They were both really high-level Motorball players. And since Keanu Reeves is older than Jai Courtney, I could think that maybe in the Alita Battle Angel cinematic universe, you know, Esdoc was the kind of the veteran, the all-time favorite, with Jashugan being the upcoming favorite, the young guy coming up, you know. And, of course, in the comic, Esdoc was the Blade Master, while Jashugan was the brawler using his machine clutch martial arts and his special gears, cybernetic body, motorball body. And of course, in the comic, it's actually Esdoc who gives Alita the Damascus blades, and not that Alita steals them from Japan, as we saw in the cinematic universe. But in any case, Esdoc is the blades master, and he was a high-level motorball player. But of course, due to an accident that happened in the past, both of them become physically injured, seriously physically injured. And the irony of the fate was that, Jashugan was able to receive a high-level treatment and was able to come back to being able to compete, but Esdoc never was able to do so. Now, I can't remember if it was because he was doing drugs, one of the drugs, like Axel or Adam. I can't remember which one was the performance-enhancing drug. But in any case, I can't remember if that was the reason or if there was something else. But of course, Esdoc does not get a chance to come back again. And that makes Esdoc extremely resentful of Jashugan. And so when Alita comes along and he manages Alita, of course, through Alita, Esdoc is trying to relive his, accomplishments. And because of that, he becomes obsessed with having Alita win, even more so than Alita. Now, of course, we know what happens in the comic, where eventually he gets so obsessed that things happen. And then, of course, there's a situation where Esdoc gets killed by a bystander. And, of course, this creates a drama that keeps on going. And I figure that this may continue to go on. I just couldn't figure out how to do that in a short period of time. However, if you focus rather than on the brooding Alita side, if you focus on the brooding Esdoc side, then you might be able to do it much quicker than you saw in the comic. And so just like in the comic, if they were going to continue on with Motorball, I would love to see Alita kind of separated from the people in, Iron City, in her neighborhood of Iron City, including, Dyson Ido. And although she can't go back and she's having difficulty and she's kind of run away from that environment to try to forget everything, it's not as much a anger that she has against Doc Ido as the Alita in the comic. If you remember the Alita in the comic, when Daisuke Ido calls out to her, she turns around and she looks at him with an extremely cold stare and then keeps on going. In this case, I would like to see Alita still very much caring of her father figure, Dyson Ido, but she just can't be with him because the moment she is with him, all she can think about is Hugo and what happened. And that brings her so far down that she has to get away from that area. And so, she comes to Motorball. She meets with Esdoc. And then he becomes her manager because, everybody wants to manage Alita. And they keep on going. He treats her very well, and he's much more a businessman sort of guy than this guy in overalls in the comic. But he treats her quite well. He seems to be a more friendlier version of a Vector, so to speak. But in any case, so she keeps on coming up the ranks. And during one of the incidents, I would love to see Dyson Ido meet Alita in the hallway. He tries to call her out. Alita looks at her, him with sadness in her eyes, trying to smile at Dyson Ido, but just can't bring the strength to do so. And so she walks away from him, just saying something like, "Please forget about me." you know, I am no good to anybody, and she walks away. Dyson Ido tries to stop Alita, but at that moment, you know, Esdoc's men, you know, get between him and Alita and just block him from being able to get to Alita. And of course, you know, there's a little bit of pressure by Esdoc's men on Doc Ido, going, who are you? You know, stop harassing our star. And he keeps on trying to get through. But of course, before any violence can erupt, Jashugan comes out from the back and goes, ah, Doc Ido, what are you doing here? You know, and of course, this makes sense. And this is one thing that I really liked about the cinematic universe is, of course, that Dyson Ido used to be the chief mechanic of all of the, you know, the motorball players. And because of that, all of the motorball players are very close to Doc Ido. So when Jashugan meets Doc Ido and he's being harassed by Esdoc's men, of course, he stands behind Doc Ido and goes, is there any trouble? And of course, Doc Ido goes, no. And Esdoc's men, of course, move away in fear because they know exactly just how strong Jashugan is. And so they go away. Doc Ido talks with Jashugan. You know, Jashugan asks whether Doc Ido would come back. And of course, that brings up the pain from Doc Ito's side about thinking about his daughter Alita, and he declines. However, I would love to see something like Jashugan saying, if you don't mind, I would like to talk with you for a little while to see if I can convince you to come back. You know, and then in whatever way, you know, in a much more dramatic way, and of course, Doc Ito tries to decline but ends up going with Jashugan. Now, of course, eventually in the next scene, you know, you don't know what the discussion is, you know, because it happens off screen. And then the next scene, you see, or eventually when you, the next time you see Jashugan, you see that Doc Ido has joined his team. Now, of course, that happens actually in the comic. And of course, what you don't know in the off screen is, of course, that Jashugan tells Ido about his situation, and basically that he has only a little bit of time left, and he's extremely frustrated because of the fact that he's getting weaker and weaker and weaker, and he can't even fight some of these top players anymore when he used to be able to walk right through them. And so he's frustrated. He wants to have a warrior's honorable death. And of course, when Doc Ido left the motorball scene, he left it because of the fact that there was really no redeeming feature in the motorball sport. He thought that it was just pure violence for the sake of violence. But by talking with Jashugan, you know, he starts understanding that, you know, this is a very honorable warrior and he only has a little bit of time left. So as much as it pains him to come back to the motorball arena, he decides to do so for the sake of this man. Now, of course, as I said, all of this happens off screen, so the viewers don't know about it. However, the next time you see Jashugan again, Doc Ito's with him. And so this then can come to that scene, you know, where Alita meets with Jashugan and they have that arm wrestling match. But before that, what I was thinking is, now that it's focused more towards Esdoc versus Jashugan, I would love to see their relationship a lot more than I saw in the comic. In fact, you know, I would like to see them as rivals who used to be really good friends. You know, Esdoc used to actually be the senior, the senpai, you know, and Jashugan was the upcoming junior potential champion. And they were good friends, you know, because they both respected each other as warriors. But after that whole incident, since Jashugan was able to come back and compete and Esdoc could not, Esdoc always resented Jashugan as being a lucky person versus his, you know, unlucky situation. And so, you know, as much as those two try to be cordial to each other, the resentment eventually swells up in Esdoc's side, and Esdoc bites back at Jashugan. So, you know, in right before that arm wrestling match, you know, it would be like nice to see it as a bar where Jashugan is drinking something as Doc sits next to him and they start talking. You know, Joshigan's going, you're not looking as good as you used to, and of course Esdoc ironically comes back and goes, why would I look any better than I did in the past, you know, considering what the situation was. And you know, I'll let Robert Rodriguez do his expert writing, and he should go talk with Yukito Kishiro, because Yukito Kishiro is really good at these types of conversations where they talk to each other, and you know, Joshigan's worried about Esdoc, that he's getting more and more darker, depressed, and it's really starting to show, and it that just pisses Esdoc off, because of the fact that, you know, it's like, who are you to tell me how I look, considering that it's you who put me into that entire situation in the first place, you know? So eventually, you know, Esdoc gets up and screams at Jashugan, just stay away. Just, you don't even know. You have no idea. You were lucky. You were damn lucky. And you're sitting here preaching to me about how I look, how I act. Get out of my way. Stay out of my life, you know? And he just walks away. And of course, that leaves Jashugan, and then he can eventually meet with Alita. Alita's pissed off because Alita cares for Esdoc, and he just saw that Esdoc got really angry at this person, so Alita's somewhat angry at him as well, annoyed at him. And of course, Jashugan introduces himself. Alita says, yeah, I know who you are. And then they go through a little bit of a discussion. She gets surprised that Doc Ido is with Jashugan, which makes her even angrier. And of course, that goes into that arm wrestling match that's in the comic. And eventually, you know, Alita continues to climb up, and she knows that she's going to eventually meet Jashugan in the arena. You know, Jashugan's starting to get better because Ido's working and trying to improve his condition for whatever short time he has. You know, and so this keeps on going on. Eventually, you know, Alita meets Ido in the hallway or wherever, you know, and they have a heart-to-heart discussion. And just like in the comic, when Alita talked about how she is not sure what her life is all about, she lost her memory, she lost the most important person in her life after she came back, you know, all the people that she knew in the past were gone, and she doesn't even know who they are. All of that has left her empty as a shell. And all Doc Ito will say, just like Daisuke Ito said, is, I know you're going through some really hard times. As much as we miss you, we understand that you need to have your time, and we'll be waiting for you when you decide to come back. Now, of course, that makes Alita think about things, and she could have, you know, her past memories with regards to Hugo and Doc Ido dwell upon her to the point where she decides that maybe it's worth going back. Now, of course, that really angers and frustrates Esdoc, as we had in the comic, and goes through that situation where Esdoc basically passes away at that point. Whether he gets shot just like in the comic, or whether he dies from his own body finally failing, I'll leave up to the directors, but he finally passes away. And then, of course, Alita feels even more mixed because of the fact that the last thing Esdoc says is, please, for my sake, for my life, beat Jashugan. And then, of course, he passes away. And so now, here's the one scene that I would love to see that wasn't in the comic, which is the funeral scene for Esdoc. And during that time, Alita's really now down because she doesn't know what to do. She feels that she's obligated to continue on, and yet she feels that maybe that's not even the right way to go to the Motorball champion. She should go back to where everybody who cares for her is, which is Iron City, and she doesn't know what to do. And that's when Jashugan sits down next to her and starts talking about herself. And of course, she gives a lot of that information. Jashugan first thanks her for being the final dream for Esdoc. You know, they were good friends. He respected Esdoc a lot, and he saw how much Esdoc cared for Alita, and he really thanked Alita for taking care of his friend. And of course, Alita says, "I never was able to fulfill his dreams." And he talks about what her dreams are. Of course, that brings up all that situation that she doesn't know what her dreams are anymore. You know, that all of this is just a mixed bag. And so at that point, Jashugan gives his story, which is how he finally tells Alita that he also is dying, that probably in the next few days he will be joining Esdoc. But one of the things that he wants to also thank is that when he saw Alita, you know, his heart raced because he saw another competent warrior coming up, just like Esdoc saw Jashugan coming up. And so that gave him the thrill of being able to challenge Alita. However, then he says, "But if you are coming in to challenge me, I want you to come in because of yourself. I don't want you to do it because of Esdoc. I don't want you to do it because of me. I don't want you to do it because of anybody like Doc Ido or any of those people. I want you to do it because of yourself. Believe in yourself. If you feel that this is the important fight, if you feel that you are a warrior spirit, which I think you are, then come into the arena by your choice, not by anybody else's." And then he stands up and walks away. Now, of course, then that gives Alita a little bit of time to dwell upon things, and she decides to go into the final championship. And of course, then it goes just like in the comic, where now Jashugan's coming back to being very strong again, and Alita sees just how strong Jashugan is, right? All the other contenders, Ajikuri and whoever, he just drives through them just the same way that he does in the comic. And he sees, you know, Alita sees this guy coming up after her, and she's scared to death, right? And in the beginning, of course, Jashugan mops the floor with Alita. But as she keeps on fighting, her memory comes back of things Gelda told her about what a warrior spirit is, the things that Hugo would have told her about how he believed in her, you know, how she said, "Well, I don't think I could be a contender in Motorball." And he says, "A contender, I think you could be a champion." All of that comes back. The things that Ido said about, you know, how she did need a warrior's body. A warrior spirit needs a warrior's body, and how she uses it is up to herself. And all of that comes back to make her realize that she really needs to be the warrior spirit that brings her back. And of course, that turns around the fight to the point where she's beating the crap out of Jashugan this time. And right at the point where she tries to give the the final blow, Jashugan, for some reason, moves at outrageous speeds, slams his fist into Alita's body, making her fly, and of course she passes out. And of course, when she comes to, she finds out that she has lost the fight. But she also finds out that Jashugan has died. The last request that Jashugan had for Doc Ido was for him to remove the limiters in his heart. And by doing so, at the last minute, if he wanted to, he could put all of the energy from the heart and overload it into one final attack, which is exactly what he did. And that was the ability to for him to beat Alita. But in doing so, he died a warrior's death. Now, of course, that then gives Alita the closure to Motorball. And the one final thing I would love to see is, of course, she's, you know, saddened by the death of Jashugan as well as the death of Esdoc. And it's at that time that Jashugan's manager comes up to her and leaves a recording, which is Jashugan's recording, which is basically says, if you see this, then it means that I am dead, and gives his entire thanks about being a warrior and requiring a warrior's death, and Alita being able to give it to her, give it to him. And so with that, you know, Alita feels a little bit better. And the manager for Jashugan says, well, I'm looking for a new player. And Alita declines. And the manager says, we understand, but if you ever decide to come back to Motorball, we will be waiting. And he walks away. And with that, closes the entire Motorball scene. And Alita, of course, goes back to Iron City with the confidence that she gained from the Motorball arc. And, of course, that perfectly sets up the situation for the Zapan arc, which is the essence of Alita Fallen Angel. Anyway, so, yeah, my feeling is by avoiding a lot of the in-depth discussions and stuff that went on between, for example, Jashugan and Shumira or Alita, you know, and Ido, but instead focus on Esdoc and Jashugan and how Alita gets sucked into that. And through Esdoc and Jashugan, Alita is able to regain her own confidence. Then they may be able to do that arc in a much shorter time while somewhat retaining a lot of the in-depth character growth essence that you saw in that particular arc. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm too hopeful. However, I thought that if you can take a great actor like Keanu Reeves, and that's why I really am hoping Keanu Reeves may play Esdoc, and it will be great, is because of the fact that for that sort of role, although it's an extremely short role, and it's a very non-violent role, which is not always what you want to see Keanu Reeves in. You want to see him as an action hero. But if you can bring him out as that brooding, depressed kind of, I need this for my final hurrah sort of deal, I think he could make a really good Esdoc to counter, you know, Jai Courtney's much more spiritual warrior, tough, you know, by the book sort of personality that Jashugan has. Anyway, that's about it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. Yeah, I apologize for just blabbing away with regards to this speculation, but I thought after talking with Revan that this may actually help in bringing out a really good Motorball scene if you can bring out a really good actor for Esdoc. And it may not have to be Keanu Reeves, but I'm really hoping that Robert Rodriguez chooses a really good actor for Esdoc, and that may be able to give closure properly to the Motorball arc. Anyway, what do you think about that? I know a lot of you out there are a lot more expert at Battle Angel Alita than I am, and I would always like to hear your comments with regards to this. But in any case, thank you very much for watching. I'll continue to make more Alita Battle Angel, Battle Angel Alita, GUNNM videos in the future. I hope you join us at that time. And until then, happy movie watching, happy anime watching, and as always, Jaya, nice day, everyone.